Right guys, as usual, dog bin first. Where are you? There you are. Secured. Gonna do the lines. Gonna do the legs now. All done. Hello guys, welcome to my YouTube channel, Truckers Lifestyle at Alfredo's YouTube channel. I've done all my checks, got two jobs, a delivery and a collection. I've hooked up already on the trailer. I've done all the necessary checks and I've gone round to check everything and everything is okay, ready to go. I'll see what route to take, which is convenient to me, which can make life easier and get the job done. Right guys, see you at the gatehouse. Right guys, just here at the gatehouse, get some clearance and then we continue with the journey. Right. Hello guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel, Truckers Lifestyle at Alfredo's YouTube channel. We picked up the A14. I'm going this route because it's always easier for me to take the A14, M11, and then I pick up the M25. Because most of the time there's always commotions on the M1, the M25, as people always cut in to get off, you know, the slip roads to pick up the junctions, and you always never know because they keep on, you know, rushing. But on this route you hardly get anybody cutting in, so you're definitely on your own driving your way, and unless really something comes up serious, but you have plenty of room, you know, to avoid anyone who would just put you into trouble. So that's why I take this route. Guys, if you're new onto this channel, please kindly do subscribe, share and like my contents, and press the notification bell to receive more videos regarding truckers lifestyle. Leave a comment down below, because I do reply to my all the comments. And if you have any suggestion regarding this channel or supporting this channel, please kindly do. And leave a comment so that we can see how best we can make sure that this channel is helpful to everyone who goes and browse on it. Right guys, we are going to Sheppey and so far everything is okay. Our ETA to Sheppey is going to be around 5 minutes past 9 o'clock, 21:05 in 24 hours time. Yeah, and then I'm gonna have a break as usual before we go, because I would have used about 3 hours of driving, and we need to have a break and come back and pick up a collection on our way back home. So guys, I'll let you know once we get onto the M11, and then we crack on. Right guys, see you in a bit. Hello guys, we are almost picking up M11, and just want to change lanes. Change lanes now. our estimated time of arrival is 21:05 on our delivery point, and we're still on the M11. Very soon we're going to pick up the M25. So I'll give you a shout once I pick up the M25. Right guys, we're on the M11, but I think there's a situation out here. It's a big fire. There's a big fire, there's a... This guy opened the door. Somebody ran into it. Jesus, car on fire. Thank you. stand in, that it should be going over like this is really, really nice. So as you know, our way of saying whatever goes up definitely comes down. We're now descending on the other side. Down below on my right hand side, you've got two tunnels, and they're all running. As I can see, they're all the traffic from the other side. All the tunnels are open. There's a time they close one tunnel, especially the one on the right, the high tunnel, which is 16 something. It's always they always close it for maintenance and other reasons. One on the right, on the far left, when you're coming back, is used mostly with fuel tankers. Fuel tankers always have to queue up if they're numbered about 6 or 8. I don't know how many they do release. Then they escort them through the tunnel. The police escort them through the tunnel. Right from start to the end without any cars following, so they just make sure that all the fuel tankers are escorted through the tunnel, and once they get over the other side, then they release the tunnels to other road users. It's all because of safety. Right guys, we are now going to pick up the M2. We're not going on the M20. We're going to go via the M2, which shows that there is no closures whatsoever. I think it's open. Otherwise, I would have had. Signs displayed. I would have seen the sign displayed, but we're going to take the M2 all the way to junction 4, which is going to take us to Sheppey. We're going to pick that 249, I guess. Yeah, that's going to take us to Sheppey. So everything is running tickety-boo, so bear with me. Come along and I'll show you how best to get to Sheppey once you've crossed the Dartford crossing. So cross the Dartford crossing, you keep on the M25 and pick up the M2. Best hobbies that they really feel and make them happy. time is still set, no change. 21:05 managed to make up that time where we lost it a bit, where there was traffic and where there was a car fire, we had to slow down. But all in all, we're going to be at Sheppey at that time, 21:05. Offload, have a break, turn and burn, go to Peterborough, pick up the collection, and then head back to base. So right guys, I'll speak to you later on. Just passing the services now, midway services. You've got all the restaurants on the flyover there, as you can see at the top. So at the stop, Burger King and all that, Costa Coffee. There's a big services there. So I do stop there a couple of times, but today we're quite early and I don't need to stop until 2300. By 2300 we'll have already even offloaded the cargo, because normally you have 4.5 hours driving time. Before your 4.5 driving time, you should have a break of 45 minutes. The European rule, the 6-hour rule, whereby every 6 hours you're supposed to have a 15 minutes break. So if you manage to get away with it before or after, well, you can. But it's good if you have a quick smooth run, then you don't need to stop twice, so you just on the stop for your 4.5 hours drive, which is good. But if you have delays picking up your load, and then you're forced to have a 15 minutes break. Well guys, I mentioned a while ago, my apologies, it's always confuses me. I've been here when they close this junction 5 and we had to go all the way to 4 and then turn around. But it is M2, you go off on junction 5 to go to Sheppey and then pick up the 249. It's to close this slip road, and you have to go all the way to junction 4, come back, go off the slip road, and then go on the other side of under the bridge. But it's junction 5, not 4. But like guys, I mentioned a while ago that it's not junction 4. So you said M2 after the Dartford Tunnel, Dartford crossing. Pick up the M2, come all the way to junction 5, that's where you go off. Then from junction 4, we're going to pick the 8249, which is going to take us to Sheppey. It's been a nice smooth ride, thanks God. I've not really felt it. The only problem is if you leave late or you get held up somewhere, and then it comes up on you, and then you feel that, you know, the run is long, but it's not long, it's just, it gets longer because of certain situations whereby, you know, you're forced to delay. Today it seems that it's been quite easy and fast. So, yeah, this bend, one day people are going to come rushing, can easily tip you over if you're not careful. Right now we've got, here we're picking get to the gatehouse. Right guys, we're crossing, going over the Sheppey Bridge. At least this time it's not windy. We're not going to go underneath while we're coming back. And lucky enough, I've got a box, it's not a curtain. The other time I had a curtain and I didn't want to risk to go on top while it was very windy. So we had to go underneath the bridge. There's the old road that goes underneath the new one. So if you feel that you can't drive over the new one while it is windy and you've got a curtain sight, you might as well take the other route, which is safe, because you never know, you don't want to be blown off this bridge, man. Right guys, as you can see, the red and green lights flashing at the far end on the left is where we're going. That's where we're going to offload the cargo. And I've noticed that you can't use the overhead bridge while you're coming back because they're working on it. I've seen a maintenance vehicle there. So everyone, all the traffic is being diverted to the old bridge where you go under the normal one. I've just noticed it, yeah. I didn't see any vehicles coming up. So right guys, I'll speak to you once we get to the gatehouse to get clearance to go and offload, guys. See you in a bit. Here we are, Aldi. Right guys, we are here right on time, ETA 21:05 on the dot. Lovely jubbly. Good. Let's get this in. Right guys, on the bay now, just got to go back and start offloading. Hello guys, just arrived here at Aldi. I'm going to do the usual offload and then have a break and then hit the road and go pick up the collection. See you guys in a bit. Hello guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel, Truckers Lifestyle at Alfredo's YouTube channel. Finished offloading now, just got to go and look for a place where to have a break and then head to Peterborough to pick up that collection. So guys, just gonna have a quick break and then we go to Peterborough. Just gonna look for a place where to park. Right guys, gonna have my salads and sandwiches as usual. Got my sandwiches there. I've got a drink. I think what drink do I have? I think a juice, yeah. Orange juice. Got somewhere in the bag. Just gonna have a quick break and then hit the road. So that's it. That's it, yeah. The juice, sandwiches, and salads. Right, guys. Hello, guys. Welcome back to our YouTube channel, Truckers Lifestyle. Break is over, guys, and ready to hit the road. I'll keep you updated as we go along, and we see how we get to pick up the collection. See you, guys. A lovely day. Some checks on the bridge to see us getting loose or what, that needs to be prepared or taken attention, so it goes in, so that checking you can see the other trucks on the other side, top of the bridge. The good thing is it's not even windy today, so a couple of times it comes very, very windy. Up there when once it's really blowing. Yeah, well guys, this is the old Sheppey bridge. It's used to open and then close for the ships to go through. Think that there's any ships that normally go through. I don't think they ever even open it, because it seems it is sealed now by the looks. But that bridge used to unfold when the ships would pass through, and then it goes back to normal. Guys, we're through now. Let's go to go back and join the M25. It's the meantime. Try and check that today the boys are not here. There's always some youngsters, they come here their cars and mess about, try and race around. But I think they're always being stopped by the police, because they make it a habit every day to race around, which is illegal. Right guys, we're gonna go back onto the A429. Take us back to the M2 and then we proceed. Right guys, I'll keep you posted. Right guys, for the first time I've come across this M25. It's always closed. It's only today that it's open, but then still I can see some flashing signs. I think it's the tunnel which is closed. It should be one tunnel closed. Yeah, definitely. The right-hand tunnel, right-hand side, the 16.6 feet is closed, the taller tunnel. And the 15.9 is open, so if you have a higher trailer, you'll be forced to go the other way around. So that shows that it's closed, because you see the two lanes being moved. Queue up, they just use that one. guys, if you've not been onto this channel and it's your first time, guys, this is the tunnel I've always been talking about. The Dartford crossing. We've got two tunnels going underneath the sea. Deep underneath the sea, and then you got the bridge which is on top that we normally cross over when we're coming south. Yeah, so right now we're getting to this tunnel, and it's 1 mile long. It's a 1 mile long tunnel. Picked up the M11, just come off the M25, picked up the M11, and got about 1 hour and 20 minutes to get to Peterborough. So just taking it easy, get there, pick up the collection, and then head to base. Guys, picked up the trailer, dock been insecured. Yeah. Alright guys, we are just about there, just gone off the A1 and approaching the collection point. Let's see what they have for us. If you have something, fair enough, we'll pick it up. If not, then we call it a day. There's our man here. Security. It's not security these days. Looks quiet, but there's a number of trailers on the bay. So let's find out if number two is coming off. Cured. Tires okay. Nuts. Airbag. Tires, nuts. There's airbag, nuts. Go close the door. Let me just get the number plate. Right, I'll get the number plate. Right, loaded, put the number plate, get it. I don't know why these guys, they don't put the doors down, so simple. And that's why these things. Right guys, all done. Just gonna go pick up my paperwork and go. Hello guys, all done. Got this delivery collection. I've picked it up and just heading back to base. Everything is okay. I've checked the trailer and I've done all my checks. I'm just heading back to base, so I'll need to end up this video. If you're new onto this video, into this channel, please kindly do subscribe, share and like my contents. Press the notification bell to receive more videos regarding trucker's lifestyle. Leave a comment down below, because I do reply to comments. So we picked up the load, guys. I see you in the next one. Ciao for now.